Hey friends, welcome back to another video. Currently at $45 at the moment with $30 CS dollars. So hopefully what we're trying to go for now is we're still trying to break through the shrimp. We need 6,000 points all up. We're around 2,000 at the moment. I got to the 20th. Today we're at a bit of, today's the 8th here. So we've still got 12 more days to make 4,000 points, and I think we could easily do that. I think we could average, while we're on holidays, we could probably try and get there, within a week easily, I think, because we've already made a third of the way, and I think we've been going at it for about 3 days so far, so to get 3 days into about 2,000 points is not too bad, so maybe in 9 days, hopefully we get it. The other plan is to, once we're going to find out how high we can go with the fish ranks to get as much cash back and the spins as we can get. Once we hit our peak and we're stuck at our limits because we can't actually get higher cash back because you're still at the micros, then we can go towards a platinum cash back, which will be like a 20% rake. So once we realize that we can't actually make the cash back, we'll actually make the points to satisfy the fish. That's the fish buffet. Then we'll have to go back to, then we'll go to platinum, but you've got to bear in mind, you've got 15 days, I think you're stuck with platinum before you can go back into the ranks, but that's fine as well. I think you can change it any time, it's just, it's stuck, you've got a bit of a time limit before you change back. So I think that's the way to go. Also, another thing we've got to do is, thanks for all the feedback and the comments and all that. Sometimes it probably feels like I'm a little bit slow to react. It's because I'm a few videos ahead of what you guys are seeing. So that's fine, but we are moving things forward. We've upgraded. Hopefully we don't get as much feedback in the background. Sometimes the kids and the wife, they can say inappropriate stuff. So just understand. I mean, if you could put your computer in the worst spot to play poker and grind and try and concentrate, you've got where my computer's set up. So pretty much in the middle of a train station, central train station where the most population is. That's probably where my computer is in the house. Okay, so just bear with the noise. Sometimes it happens. Anyway, sometimes I'm a bit more quieter when I do a video because when I've got people around me, I don't like to talk as much. I get a bit shy around all the people around me. Not really shy as such, but I just don't like being loud with other people around, respect other people's, noise levels and all that stuff. So anyway, guys, another one too. So we've put the camera on. You can see my lovely face now, which is nice. Let me know how you guys think of the videos, how they're going. What format do you prefer? We're going to stick with this so much. We are definitely starting to tighten up. So we're going to tighten up our range a bit. So our three betting range, we've probably gone a bit nuts lately. I've been three betting with queen four suited type hands and all that stuff. But yeah, anyway, let's get into it because for some reason the computer doesn't like me now. So okay, for some reason it just didn't, it's kicked me out of the seat, but that's fine. But anyway, what I was going to say is we're going to go with queen nine. Actually, I'm going to leave this table. So we need to make sure we've got all the tables available to us. This person's rude enough to join our seat, but he's not really rude. It's just that we timed out. Maybe they don't like it. All right, so we need to fix up two more tables and then we're good to go, and then I'll put some beats on and you don't have to hear my voice. We're going to talk about a couple of hands, but yeah, definitely going to tighten up the three betting range. That's probably the main thing. Top pair hands, we need to do more pot controls. So top pair, okay kicker, we're going to try and get the showdown as cheap as possible and try and keep their bad ranges in check, so then we can actually keep them on the board. So if you play too aggressive, you're only going to be, when you get the showdown, you get a run into their better hands. So you just don't want that. So top pair, top kicker, definitely with a draw, with a board like this, it's quite scary. But we're going to be very aggressive here anyway. So anyway, guys, without further ado, I'm going to get dealing in. All right, so I've got to join in the cash and run now. Sometimes you can be careful because sometimes you hear the dunk. When you hear the dunk sound, That means I'm running out of time with the time bank. We get 60 seconds to react, and that's fine as well. All right, there's a table I'll need to fix up somewhere. Hopefully run into it soon. But yeah, sitting at 45, we've had two sessions where we've been okay. We're at about 50, I think we're at 55 yesterday. Then we went down to 49, and now at the moment we're down to 45. So thought I was recording the last session, but there was no record. But there was a lot of noise in the background, so in a sense I'm glad I didn't record it. But anyway, could go from here. King Jack's gonna get folded. King Queen definitely a betting. I gotta call. I'm not gonna 3-bet. Pocket threes is definitely a 3-betting range. I'm gonna fold pocket jacks. I could probably called there, but if I'm wrong, there's definitely a scenario where we've got to be careful. Okay, so this is fine. We just had to find that table that was still half open. We found that was fine. No stress there. Did 3-bet against the Lipper, but it was already 2 cents, so it's not going to break the bank. And hopefully we start winning more sessions again, and then get upwards of 60 plus. And then that way we can play a bit more aggressive, and we're not too stressed about, you know, losing sessions. And then we can focus on when we win sessions, we should be able to win by heaps. But at the moment, we sort of get affected by bad sessions. Because once you get below $30 bankroll, it does affect you a little bit. Not going to say it doesn't. It would affect anyone, I think. But we did have a cushion with also the C dollars as well. So you got to remember, we still got that. So essentially, we've still got about 75, I think it is, in the bankrolls department now, so that is fine. Also, we're playing so much now, the feedback from the wife is not impressed, but she doesn't realize what we're doing here anyway, but she doesn't need to know. She just needs to know that we're being, responsible. And that's the main thing, you need to be responsible. And, you know, if we're good enough, we'll move up in the ratings, move up in the ranks. At the moment, we're just not good enough, and it's good to see that some people actually understand that the reason why we don't move up in the ranks. Jack 10 just misses everything there. You know, sometimes you just can't rush things. It's a bit frustrating, I know, but, you know, at the moment, we can't be, we just can't be rushing. Because we're just not playing optimal enough yet. Once we get a bit more consistent, well, that's a bad run out as well. But we didn't put too much in the chips in the pot, which is fine. And you got to remember at this level as well, if you're wondering why I'm not bluffing as much, it's because they never fold really. They don't care about your hands. They don't care. They're not thinking about your hands at this level. They're thinking about theirs, and that's about it. So that's why when I check raise huge, because they're gonna pay me off. If they like the hand, they're gonna call me off. They will go broke. You know, even with their pocket aces, their pocket kings. You've seen it heaps of times where I'll have two pair and I'll just score huge against the big blind. And that's why sometimes I do call quite wide. Especially when I'm dealer against the big blind, because you just know they're gonna have a strong ace. And if they hit, they're not going to let go. And then as soon as we hit our, you know, trips or set or two pair, as long as the board's not that scary, we should be fine most of the time. And it's as easy as that. Put yourself in an easy scenario. Sometimes it's not a great call, but you got to sometimes you got to make bad calls. If he's got an ace with totally royally stuffed there, it was like the worst run out for trips. Yeah, see, could even have Queen Jack there now, especially with the aces. It's tragic, absolutely tragic. And he could even have a king there and scare us off the cards, which is terrible as well. But the time he does that, and then we do have a bigger hand, well, he's going to regret shoving into us, because he's going to find out our nuts. And that's the reason sometimes why you've got to be really careful of how you bet into a hand. And think about your opponent's ranges as well. Alright, I'm going to call Jack 6. It's very wide, but... Okay, we scored pretty well there. Not going to lie. 4-3 suitors didn't hit well, though. I'm going to bet there. Who knows? If he's got King Jack, we're in trouble, though. But he could have Ace King, and he's not going to let go. Going to try and be a little bit more aggressive with our draws as well. Because I don't want to just be known as the person who's betting when we have it made. Because then people will know when we bet, they can easily beat us. So that was a scary call, actually, but got a king. He's probably got a good ace. He's going to rip it in. Hit our card, luckily enough. That should be our first hand that we've won pretty well. If not, we probably should at least have a dollar. If he folds, we've made a dollar in that hand. Okay, get to see it soon. Got king, queen, two pair, which is nice. All right, get a flat. Really need to see another king. He must have folded, actually. I got two pair. I can't. Oh, actually, if he's got an ace. Now, if he's got an ace, he's actually beating us. So we have to fold there. There's too much. All the hands that we beat, he's now in front. And if you can't beat anything, you got to fold out of the way. And trips are one of those hands where they look very, very. They look very pretty. And you'll lose a lot of money on them. So you can't overestimate trips. Okay, we've got a flush draw there. There's a lot of straights there as well. Miss everything, unfortunately. So that's a shame. So you've got to be aware when we're playing this many tables, we're going to have quite an influx. So what I think at the moment is our game seems to be leveling out a bit. So that means that our losing sessions aren't going to be as bad. So that means that we're not going to get... I don't think we're going to have those big losing sessions like we did in the past, like, you know, five buy-ins. I don't think that's going to happen, at least, like, you know, five plus buy-ins, you're going to lose like $20, whatever it is. I just don't see that happening as much. But what we'll do, we'll see, is hopefully we'll see a $10 gain, $20 gain eventually. So we'll just have to... go from there and just hopefully we'll play quite aggressive though. See if we can get some of these wins. And just win pots aggressively as well. We don't want to be passive, especially at these levels. Especially when they fold when you sneeze at them. So, you know, that's the amount. I don't want to fold there because we've got a flush draw. Any excuse to call. If he bets big there, we've got to probably fold. All right, so check behind. We don't want to get put off the hand. It's probably the worst club on the board to get because now if he's got an 8 or a 7, he just has a boat and we just lose. And there's always a chance he's got a bigger club, but a bigger club flush. But I just don't see it. But anyway, yeah. Anyway, so yeah, the main goal is at the moment, while we're still on holidays, we're trying to get through as many fish rankings as possible before we have to, I'm trying to work out in my head how many sessions I could play a week. I've worked out I can play probably 5 sessions. Like an averaging session would be like an hour and a half. Seems to be the sweet spot for me between an hour and a half, an hour and a half to 2 hours, depending. And then I like to have And once we get over 100 bankroll, I'd really enjoy slipping in the tournaments like on a Friday night as well. And that's somewhere we can sit for like hours on end trying to, you know, make it deep into a cash tournament and then trying to win a couple hundred dollars if we can and really boost things up. And then hopefully by that time, we've improved enough that we could play at a lot of different levels above us. So hopefully by then we can actually prove we can actually hold ourselves at 10 NL, 5 NL, stuff like that. If we want to make it to, say, I think it's the Octopus Platinum range, there's one where you need 750,000 points, and you need to average, I worked it out, you need to average like 2,000 points a day, and there's just no way. We could probably average between probably about 200 to 300 a day, maybe. Even that's still a tough ask, but at the moment we can do it because we're playing quite a lot. Okay, got an open ender. It's going to go for kings all the way. Definitely get some value for the kings. I'm not going to get too scared with kings and aces. I mean, you're going to... Ooh, that was a bit crazy with the other one. I did bet quite big there with eights. Missed it with the 9-8, but still cheap enough pot. Hopefully everyone folds with the pocket eights. Usually when I do bet on the turn, it usually represents something quite strong. So that's what I'm saying. I need to add some more... bluffs in my range, especially in the drawing department. Yeah, we get a gut shot. Someone just punched us. That means we actually had a good hand. It means he folded when we had pocket eights, which is fine. Okay, we still haven't really made a good hand yet. Maybe we've lost with the pocket kings. Or maybe he just folded. That's fine as well. Anyway, we're happy the way we play pocket kings. Not got a flat there, but we're in position. Maybe I could have called there. Okay, if he's got a two, we're just dead to the water pretty much there. Best thing about being in position, you can always check behind and get a free card and reassess the situation on the turn. Because, you know, one card could mean everything. And we can call an extra card as long as we've got the price to do it. You need to actually make sure we can give yourself the hands to draw. You know, if you've got a drawing hand, make sure you've got the hands to do it. Look, if we were out of the hand on the flop, we don't have that draw now. 10 cents isn't expensive, especially if you can think of that you can definitely beat him even more. All right, I'm going to check behind there. I think we're pretty good most of the time with the ace. I don't think he's calling any bets there, though. All right, so we did our best there, but we missed. Also, we had the five on the river as well, would have been a straight. So I had a lot of outs to get to the river. And sometimes you're just not going to make it, and it's just part of the variance. You know, some days, you know, there's times where you could spend weeks and weeks and you could play the best hands perfect. This probably happens when you're playing less tables, though, but... When you're playing perfect and you keep losing, just for a brief period, but when you're playing over a course of this many tables, you're not going to be losing every single table. You're going to be at least winning half the tables, and then preferably you're losing less than you're winning on the other tables. And then eventually, what we can do is I could have probably three bet there with Queen Jack, but it's part of the tight range. I'm changing up now with the three betting, because I find if you three bet and then C bet, you could spend a lot of money just by whiffing it and just missing out on the flop. So it's not too bad to call it in position against the big blind with certain spots. King Jack offsuit is not a great hand, especially under the gun. I mean, King 3 there's just in their hand. He could have actually bet there maybe with it, because if he doesn't have a 10, we didn't play it in a certain way. Okay, we're in position. I'm not going to call with ace high. You'd rather be the one shoving than the one actually calling, because you need a better hand to call than to shove, because when you're shoving, you just need to beat people folding. But when you're calling, you need to actually make sure you beat their hands. So just remember that. Okay, there's a 10 on the board. When he had second best pair on the board. Could be overpairs on that. Yeah, he could have overpairs. Could have a lot of everything. King 2 suited. Everything's going well here. We have a 10 with pocket 9, so we won't fold. Probably could have bet with Ace Jack, just for the fact that there's a lot of draws out there now. Ace King didn't get any love. He just rips it with aces. Yeah, King suited hand just didn't get any love there. It all suited. Just gotta remember to, especially at these at the cash and run games, just gotta remember to consistently steal. And just remember when you go to the other rings, like the standard rings, they'll be watching you stealing and then they'll start reacting to you. So you've got to pay attention to what tables you're trying to steal at and what do they actually see. So you can tighten up with your stealing. But with the cash and run, you can probably steal to your heart's content. Because 9 times out of 10, they pre-fold. And you got to remember, too, with the cash and run, they've got a diagram there which actually tells them to older fold certain hands as well, which means it's actually good for you if you want to try and steal more hands because it actually helps them fold a lot more. And they'll be folding a lot more than they should be. So a lot of people think it's a big advantage being able to shut down all your hand ranges. Sure, it fixes mistakes up, but it also tightens you up too much. You might be a bit easier to read. That's what happens when you see people going over the top. Got a flush there with Queen 7 suited, which we're happy. Still got top pair, but not a good kicker. So we're just trying to stay in the hand there as long as we could. We got to showdown, which is fine. Showdown there as well. Then okay hand. We got a 3, so we're just going to call the smallest of bets because you never know, could river him. No, but it didn't hurt. And I've got a 3-bet with Jack 3 suited. We're just going to shut that down. Sometimes we just get carried away. But we're going to try and clean up the game a little bit. All right, there's 2 people in the hand. I'm going to let go there now. I think we need at least 2 pair there to at least beat 2 people. Because you've got to remember when there's 2... Like, when you're up against heads up, you know, top pair, top kicker is not a bad hand. But even against 3-ways... It, 1 pair of hands not good enough, and we didn't even have top pair, top kicker. We only had, a bad kicker as well. We're just pretty much hoping the board. But we got to the showdown cheap. That's what we were trying to do. Need an 8 for this one, Jack 10. So we're going to call. There's diamonds on the board now, so it could actually be drawing dead, so we just fold. You don't want to be in there. Some people actually don't chase the straight if there's already a flush draw on the board, just to, because you're going to have reverse implied odds, especially if you hit a straight and then they get there and they've got the flush. What's worse is if you make the straight with their flush card. And it's almost like straights are meant to be broken in this game. Yeah, you flop, how many times, just think about it, how many times have you flopped the straight on the flop and it gets beaten by a flush, full house, just something better. Yeah, a straight can be great, especially on a dry board because you're up against usually a set if you're getting a lot of action. If the board doesn't pair up, you're laughing most times. Sixes are going. Another thing too is you can make sometimes some crazy calls, some bad calls, but profitable calls. So if you got players with a really good hand and you know they're not going to fold, and if you make your hand and they're going to pay you off, then you could probably call a little bit wider with your hands, knowing that, you know, you beat, but that one card that comes up, you're going to get paid really quick. I actually want to call. I should have just checked there. I should have checked called there. That was a mistake. We get thrown off our hands. Get a raise here with trip eights. Poker fours get to the showdown. We could actually be good there. Might just hopefully don't run into higher pockets there. Sometimes you just run into like sevens or eights or something, some crappy pair, but they still beat you. But sometimes what they do is they have whiffed with ace high hands, king high hands. And then you actually just win a nice little 20 cent pot. So that's not too bad. Right, I've got a bet here, just the fact that there's no action there. I'm going to use position rather than our cards. You've got to remember to use position as well. Sometimes they let you know that they've got nothing. just be paying attention. I know it's hard seeing it this way, but in the back of your head, you've got to remember the action. So if I 3-bet, I've just got to remember ace, 10, 3-bet in the back of your head. And think of it as a memory game. Also, another way you could think about this scenario, like the way we're playing here, think of it as you're running a test. So every time the screen comes up, you're getting another question. How would you play this hand? How would you play this hand? Okay, so we actually went for the steal before. And don't worry about the results, because you never see the results. You see the bottom. You actually see the bottom actually saying, you know, if we pass the test, at the bottom, you see the money go up. So see it that way, okay? All right, I've got the ace of hearts. We're betting it because we're going quite strong with draws today. We had a gut shot there, but I'm not excited though. And how often is someone going to fold the ace there? I don't think we get enough folds. Especially when you have another pitcher card there. Like, especially a 10. A lot of people won't fold a 10. All right, going to call with ace 3. Call pocket 2s. All right, going to bet again. Trip 2 seems to be going well. We got the showdown with a crap hand. That's what you want. Just keep betting strong. He just keeps calling. All right, you got diamonds. They say diamonds are girl's best friend, so it means they're not my best friends. You gotta be careful there. Unless, of course, I'm a girl. I just didn't know it. But who knows these days? Everyone categorizes. Not everyone. There's just dickheads out there. We know that. That's why I like poker. It keeps you away from the dickheads. I mean, we've got different dickheads. We're part of a family where, you know, bunch of egotistic guys. We've all got egos. We all think we're better than everyone else. And it's just fun. But there's nothing better than, you know, seeing, actually miss the days of sitting at a casino and, you know, everyone's just talking absolute garbage. And it's fun. Like, everyone's trash talking and just having a laugh. And it's just good fun. Especially when you have a good table, good chatty table. Friggin' hearts. I'm going to call one more. Who knows? If we get a king, we're laughing. If we don't get a king, we're not happy. We're probably just going to check behind. I can't... a 9. Okay, we're calling. The only hand that we do lose to is a 9. Which is probably... If he's still there, maybe that's the reason why. But we didn't play it. We didn't play it aggressive. So he should have a lot of his other range. He should have a lot of hands in his range. Which, you know, he can't be bothered folding. So he's just going to bet into me. And that's what you want to. You don't want to play in a sense where you just corner someone into just having the best hand. Pocket jacks. We're going to call one just for the hope of getting a jack. Okay, top pair. Okay, kicker. So we're going to play that to the river, hopefully. Okay, so he slowed down. So that was quite interesting. Didn't get anywhere. We've got two paired now with 5-4. Right, I'm going to let go of top pair. There's a lot of fours there. I don't know what he's got, but I don't think jacks are good, but it looks okay. And two pair, we're going to love at the moment. We're just going to keep betting that to our heart's content. Unless he gives us a reason not to, but... And we could probably bet the river as well. Really? Right, I'm just going to shove him. If he's got his beat, he's got his beat, but he could have ace king there a lot of the times. Yeah, he's got pocket kings, didn't want to let go. So you got to realize you can be beat there. But and I did take the cash out. When I decided not to take the cash out the other day, I seem to have lost a lot of coin flips. I do know it's like 10% equity, like you guys said. And I think overall, I think if I'm 90-something plus percent, I probably shouldn't opt for it. But especially between... 80 to 90%, I probably should actually go for the cash out. I'm just going to keep betting there, just barreling. We've got a full house with the eights. I'm not scared of anything. Hopefully he re-jams us. You know, if we're losing, we're losing. So be it. That's just poker. All right, got a 4-bet with kings. King 10 needs a 9, but is it going to happen? Hey, King 10 needs a... What do we need? Oh, I need a queen or a 7. All right, I need a queen or a 7. Okay, nice. Pocket kings actually get the cash out. Beautiful. Caught someone else. So far, so good. Seems to be a good session so far. The jury's still in, though. As long as you're still at the table, you can still lose everything. All right, need a 6 or a 5 just to keep the clubs at bay. And then we can go to Value Town. All right, got to check behind. Hopefully get a 6 or a 5 on the river. Wow. We're going to raise it huge. And if he's got the ace, he's just going to pay it off. And he'll probably throw an egg at our face. It's not a good session unless you get an egg. They usually throw eggs in. It's just an emote. And also they punch you as well. They got a punching thing as well. I think it's pretty cool, the emotes here, but we don't really have time for that when we play multi-table like this. I'm going to call behind with Queen 10. It's not a great hand, but you sometimes get miracle flops. Ace King whiffed. We're not going to... Ooh, Ace 2. We need 10 or a heart. It's starting to shape up pretty good. Alright, not throwing in too many bluffs there. Alright, Ace King's is gone. We just missed it. There's no point... no point betting into something that we don't have any value in. Ace 2, how did we miss? We just did. But we didn't actually bet the draws, so that's fine. Fives, we'll call 5. I think sometimes, what do you reckon? Sometimes calling a bet of the same value of your cards, so say if it's 6 cents or $6, but you're holding pocket sixes, you're more likely to call and think it's a good omen. Sometimes you can. I don't know. Probably it doesn't exist, but it's just a bit of fun to entertain you. There's a 4 of hearts. I'm going to call just the fact that we can actually chase. Could have a lot of good turn cards there. All right, need a 4. All right, it wasn't a bad card for what we got. All right, need a 6 or a 3. I'm going to call one more because now I've got a double gutter. Ace 9 is gone. Found a reason to call with 9-5. Probably not the greatest flop for 9-5 though. All right, so we just missed everything. That's fine. Ace queen suited, beautiful. Got a 3-bet ace queen. Somehow I missed again. We'll have to bet at jack 9. We're not happy with it, but we're going to bet it because we can't probably win showdown. If he's got an ace or a king or a queen high, if he's got any high that's higher than a jack, he just beats us. So throw a bet there and hope he's missed out on his hand and then we just win. Sometimes if it doesn't make sense to bet, they're going to call anyway, but sometimes we get a miracle set on the river and then means that they're going to more likely pay us as well. Unless it's the cash and run tables and then they're not really paying attention to us. All right, hit a pair. All right, we're in position. I'm going to call. Top pair, shit kicker. It's fine. I'm going to play a bit aggressive there. Same thing again. Got spades, so we're gonna bet it. 6-4 suited under the high cliff, the high low, it's pretty bad, but we're gonna do it. Pocket 10's pretty scary. We're calling off a lot actually, gotta be careful. Missed our hand, Jesus. Could have probably let it rip. But like I said, if they're not folding enough, those moves don't exist. Okay, pocket aces, just gonna keep betting there. I think we're actually good there. We've got a straight. So I'm gonna actually bet the straight. What's the chances of him having like a set there? Probably low. Probably he'll have like before the river, he probably had, you know, a better hand than us. Maybe lost the hand there. All right, hit two pair, nice. 7-6, get a call. Now I get a fold, actually. These nine misses. Keep going with 3-2. Hit two pair. Just don't want the board to pair up. If the board pairs up, we're dead. Yeah, just continue betting. I think we're fine there a lot of the times. He's going to keep betting until he tells us otherwise. 8-6, I really wish it was suited, but it's not. So we didn't even have a flush draw there. Got to remember to steal, steal, steal. Pocket 9 is definitely 3-betting. Got to fight with pocket 8s. Normally I do raise the pocket 8s, but not this time. Alright, pocket 9s are going to bet like we've got the ace. If they call the flop, we're in trouble. Alright, I think I flooded the 8, so doing a C bet there is just not strong. This is not a good... Alright, I got a raise there with the queens. Hopefully he's got pocket jacks. Jacks all the way... Oh, 8s go all the way to the river. Usually, he might go for a thin value bet on the river. Pocket 9's no good. We did try and bet on the flop, but it failed. Some 3-betting going on that's not us. Alright, I don't think 2s are good there. Alright, I got a C-bet with pocket 10s and just hope that we get there. Alright, he calls, but now we've got club draw. Our club could be good. He bets pretty weak, but means he's probably got like... I'm going to call one more just because of club. It's probably a wide call. Probably shouldn't have called the pocket tens, but probably could have let it go. A little bit reckless, actually. But if it's a club, we could probably, who knows, I think we could have been stealing it. The way he's been betting it, I don't think he wanted a club out there. King 10 suited, get nothing. It's been raining non-stop for 2 days now. Let's go. 10-6 suited, beautiful. Alright, Got a fold there. Okay, so we've got a reason to bet there. We've got a bet with the hearts. Problem is, when you start betting with draws all the time and you miss, it starts getting quite, and they're not folding, it can get quite, quite expensive. So you just got to be aware if your folds aren't getting through, you need to tighten up, probably with your betting range. Okay, we hit a 5, which is it's a start. If we get a 2, that'll be nice. Ace-queen, we whiff it. 6-5, we do have showdown, baby, but it's not great. Ace-2, ooh, here we go, get a rip it. We're not a river, but at least bet 3-quarter pop. Alright, got a bad kicker for the ace. Can at least call one, and then we get to the river. Hopefully he doesn't bet again. If he bets again, I think we can call a light bet. If he bet's too big, maybe he's got his beat. But if he checks behind now, maybe he's got like the second pair. And he's just valuing himself in, trying to see where he was on the turn, which we're better hand anyway. The Sun's got news. He just defeated Mario World. All right. Queen nine suited. What were we thinking being in that hand? All right, we got a straight there with the check. And sometimes it's funny, like sometimes you'll be in a session where people will, have you ever been in a certain situation where people will play any two cards and they know they can beat you because you're just playing, you're just not getting the cards at all. And they just feel invincible. And you know they're bad players, but they're just invincible. And that's very frustrating sometimes when that happens. All right, got to the river with ace 10, which is nice. Probably could have called there. Got an open ender with 8-5. Need a 9 actually. There's a maybe the sky is straight there. Jack 9 suited didn't get much help though. I hit the river with the jack. Is it enough? I'm not 100% convinced. We're gonna actually bet there with straight. We're not scared of the flush. He's gonna let us know if he's got the flush though. They need a 9. Alright, running behind a little bit here, so I need to speed up the hands. Alright, back in time. Just didn't get the straight. It's a shame. Hit a set with 9s, it's nice. Hopefully we start getting some hands, because I feel like we're running a little bit quiet so far. Okay, see, half bet, which means that he's got something, but he's scared. He's trying to keep the price down. As I said that, we're running into some hands now. Alright, we hit a set with queens. If he jams us, then we'll have to just reassess, but I think he's just going to call behind him. We win a lot of times there. Ah, we're just going to call. If he's got a straight, so be it. Aces, we're going to bet quite big there. Yeah, maybe he's got a straight there, but... don't like king queen. Don't like king queen on that board with aces. We're gonna rip it anyway. If he's got ace king. Yeah, if he's got ace king, it's the best scenario, which he did. Just can't be scared with aces as much. Yeah, it was a nice hand for us. Somehow we missed the open ender, which is sad. Continue the aggression with queens. We're not scared at the moment. Unless they give us a reason to be scared, but even still, we get that. Fight fire with fire. Looks like we might have lost that hand with trip queens though, which is a shame. Oh no, maybe we won that as well. Maybe it was on the same table because we're now over about $6, which is nice. Not calling there. Everyone's going pretty well because we're going all right. We're going around this session so far, I think. Ace Jack, we're just ripping it. I don't know why, but it's just the fact that it's the gold table. A lot of them could fold there as well. You win an extra pot for nothing. It's always nice. If it doesn't come back up, it means they all folded and we're laughing. Yeah, I think that's the case. Hit a three. Someone's hit a straight, it looks like. Alright, we'll call with pocket pair. We do have an ace of diamonds, so we're more likely to call. We don't want to bet with 7-6. We've got an open ender, but we don't want to bet it. Okay, we've got a bet there. We've got diamonds. The flush. Got to check raise, actually. Unless I checked behind there, which is stupid. I think I checked behind there. Which is bad. Ah, no, I didn't. It's going to rip the turn. Just go from there. Let's see what he wants to do. Alright, need an 8 there. Got a bet there. We got a flush draw, straight draw. Beautiful hands. But we know they don't come through enough. Do some steals. Going to make some calls. Looks like they folded. Maybe I should have just called. I should have just called there on the turn. Still a nice hand anyway. Ace queen we need. Definitely need a jack there. Alright, there we go. Thank you. Thank you for listening. Top pair okay kicker is raising. Jack 10 would miss. There is a chance that he was chasing his draw as well, so. No. Okay, he just bets into us. Remember, we checked on the turn, so we did save money there, just in case, and we did bet the flop. It's heads up in that table. Got a fold there. Ace 8 suited in a ball bet. It's pretty disgusting. I gotta bet we're gonna bet there with the diamonds just to try and beef up the pot a little bit just in case. I'm gonna call with tens. This four's gonna be good enough there. So if he goes to the river, I think our tens are good. We're letting go of tens if he bets again. We could easily have an eight there. I don't know what he's... I'd say he's got an overpair. Sometimes by the turn, they let it go. Letting them go. We'll call one there. We've got a 10, it's showdown value. Not that much value. Alright, we've got this ace of spades. So we've got a reason to stay in the hand, especially if it goes running around a spade. Ace 9 is just no good there. Now with the king coming out. We are trying to tighten up a little bit. Okay, pocket queens. I normally don't have hands on those boards, but it seems to be having a raising hand every time now. Although pocket jacks we did go probably a little bit crazy with. Not happy with that song, actually. That's a terrible song. All right, so we didn't 3-bet because we didn't get 4. We didn't want to get 4-betted with ace. I think it was ace 5 suited. But there was a reason. We can go check raise here and then try and get it in on the flop. Gonna play a little bit more aggressive today, actually. Got top pair there. Just want to make sure they know who they're messing with. Alright, so he must have folded, actually. 16 cents, we're calling him. We can't fold 16 cents after putting everything already in the pot. Alright, get a free river, which is nice. Yeah, we're actually killing him, which is fine. Pocket ace is going well. Need a bit of help with that other hand, though. Hit the 3, wow. That's not going to cut it. Aces should be good there. Just going to bet all the way. I got to rip it there. We've hit the flush on the river. We also had a straight draw as well, which would have probably been equally as nice. Especially if it looks like we're, you know, if it looks like we're bluffing there on the flop. A lot of times people will bluff on the flop, but they won't bluff on the turn. And people look at the different boards that they can bet onto. Holding there. So our pocket ace has got folded on, so that's good. We had on a little pot there. Gotta be careful, ace jack there. Gotta rip that. We hit a book. Right, I'm gonna let go of two pair there. Not happy. It's actually really hard to fold there. I mean, is he really ripping it with just ace king? I don't think so. He could have a set there as well. I've had a set in that situation and been upset. Pocket threes, probably gonna let go there. All right, flush draw, gonna bet it as usual. Just today, we're going a little bit more aggressive. Nah, actually didn't go that aggressive. Ace queen just misses everything. King nine misses everything as well. Oh, well, we tried. But we checked the turn. So if we ended up hitting our card, we could have definitely got some value in. We kept the pot low considering. Pocket 10's nice. 10-7 suited nice on the flush. Oh, that one. Ace 4's is not getting a help. Has he got a set, does he? Oh, he's gonna rip it, who cares? Let him decide. Maybe he's got a set. Hopefully he's just got a set. It's gonna come around and we just cash out. We're gonna fold 10s there. And probably could have just shoved all in there. Probably should have just shoved all in there, actually, to be fair. But you will find a lot of overpairs on that hand. Sometimes they do a lot of funky two pair hands there. But when they do it with two low cards, you can definitely board pairs up and they get counter fed pretty easy. I'm going to call there 10-6. It's not great, but got a few. We just had a few cards come through, like this one now. We've got a bet at actually. We've got a lot of equity for the river. 9-8 suitors dead now. Miss everything with King 10. Just keep them guessing. Top pair, they've got a bet. It's a vulnerable hand, so you can't just check behind sometimes. When you got a weak hand, you can go to the river as low as possible. Try and beat those small pocket pairs. Hopefully they miss everything. We're not going too bad. I think we might have lost one or two decent hands before. But we're definitely winning some as well because we've got a $5 table and a $6 table. That's huge. All right, that's good. Means we're doing something right. What are the green tables doing though? What are the dark greenies? I don't see us winning on the dark greenies. I've got $2.60 on a green. Normally I 3 bet there, but I'm not going to this time. He's just valuing me with a queen, it looks like there. So we'll get out the way. Hopefully see the pocket pair, the fours come back again, but oh, we got a $3 table, which is something. $2.20. It's not that great. All right, so two tables are going well. So three tables. I think the three tables were doing considerably well, which is fine. I just call behind. We're not going to 4 bet with pocket queens because all you got to do is run into his kings and aces, and then even his ace king. Needs a bet there with the queens because he could whiff with ace king, and he might call one, but then fold on the turn. I was just gonna bet there, just. Your hand was vulnerable. Fives, no. We just called once just to see if we get to the river. Right, two pair with A6. We're just going to bet it. Yeah, just check there. Didn't work. Continue betting quite big there. Got two pair. He could have ace queen. Probably the only hand we're worried about is ace queen there. But if he's got a strong ace, he's just going to call and going to make a little bit of money there. Don't have a club, unfortunately. Queen two suit is nice. It's not really nice, but it's nice when you're not hitting your hand to see something. We're in a blind battle. It's not a great hand now. He gave us cheap enough odds to call, actually. Probably could have called with the ace four as well. With a couple of those weaker hands. Probably should have folded pre-flop with queen nine. I said I was actually tightening up my calling range. My betting range, not my calling range, but I probably should have tightened that up too. Top pair, top kicker's in trouble there with three diamonds on the board. I'm going to bet 50 there and see if he just calls and we win. Alright, net 6 with 9-8 suited. Whiffed it with... we'll just fold there, that's fine. There is a straight out there as well. Probably could have just check called there actually. Well, we could have just check called that. Need a check calling range, or people are just going to run over you. Okay, you're straight with the jacks, which is nice. Let's see what we can do. I'm not going to call there out of position. But in position, that's a different story. I'm going to bet there like I got the jack. Alright, we did hit the 8, which is nice. Right, we just checked the king. We're just gonna bet it and see if he's gonna call. Looks like we're bluffing, but we're not. Ace 2 is no good there. Pocket 8s, there we go. Is this Dom Dollar? I think it's Dom Dollar. Oh no, Hot Since 82. That's the band that sings this song. Jacks, here we go. Jax has seen a better hand. Ace and King on there. Gotta start questioning yourself. He's got a queen, he's calling, so he just. Ace 8 gets the tip. Alright, we'll go half value for kings. Has he really got quads? I'm gonna trust it. I got a flush draw going on. I'm gonna call it. It's only the right thing to do. Unfortunately, we missed, but we do have showdown with 8, but the third, I think it's third best pair on the board. So we're not excited. Open ender, we're gonna bet it. Eventually, we're gonna hit these hands and we're gonna love it. Oh, we're gonna go bankrupt trying. It's the only card that we call a bluff on, but I'm gonna fold it. It's 4 hearts on the board. But we do beat a bluff there. That's all it is. It's a calling, it's a bluff catcher. We will 3-bet King 10 suited. We won't call a shove though. 74 hands is quite wide. Oh, I'm gonna call. Just the fact that they could be quite wide and they could have Ace King. Especially that one player looked pretty bad. If they both got Ace King, well, yeah, that was just quickly looking at their stats. And we got our queens in at the right time. Made a call, which was nice. So that hand really excites me. Got to really be paying attention to their stats, because there is still bad players out here. There's a lot of regs, but there's a lot of bad players. Probably could have played King Jack in position. I didn't actually look at his stack though, so I'm guilty at that. Steal. Well, the queen's just gonna call behind. Hopefully we get the queen. Pocket queen's probably folding there. Queen nine's just not getting anything. Shoves all in, really. Yeah, there's a couple of hands we're just letting go. Just not happy. Yep, just letting go. He's not deep enough to call. I will call 7 cents though, because we had a lot of draws coming out. We still got that gut shot. We just didn't get there. Alright, we'll throw a bet in, like we've got the flush. Because how many times have we done that? We turn up with the river flush and bet it. If he's someone that's been watching us, he's gonna fold there. Alright, got a hit a set with fives. Hopefully get raised on, he's got like a king. Alright, so we've got second nut. Got a nuttish type hand, but just don't have the ace of hearts, unfortunately. I think we're calling a shove, just because we've got the king high. The king flush. Happy gets the river with the king on the board. I think we win there a lot of times, but he could have a weak king that he's betting there. $7.20 on one, that's nice. We've got a table that's going really nice now. Someone's shoving. Need some other tables to start winning. Check the heart. Oh, check the ace actually. And we'll call the river. So I think ace queen's good there. We value the sevens because he could be trying to bet us with an ace type hand. King three, we've got a suited. I'm trying to go for five here. I gotta check and then just shove the turn. Pocket sevens is gone. No luck with ace king. We didn't put too much in the pot, which is nice. The shoving there. If he's got the ace of diamonds, flush draw. The flush. So be it. Two pair there. Valuing to King 5 there. Yeah, Really? Ah, oh, okay, there's the other table, which is nice. Gotta keep betting there, because they're on the club while we've got the best hand. Gotta defend. Recognize is no good there, I don't think. Oh, not a... Nine pairing's not that bad for us. Unless they've got nine, obviously. Alright, they've got the pocket threes, so we'll call a 3 cent. 2 cents, we did hit. We whipped it, but we got a, we did hit another, we got a hand that we missed, but we hit really big with, I think, trip nines. Nice. Two pair, top two set. Yeah, nice. Ace king we missed. Ace nine we missed. Plus draw. Now we've got insurance. I need to play a little bit faster just so we don't fold any hands by mistake. Hit the book with nines. Nice. Got some really nice hands coming through. Should be winning quite a lot. Should be on a heater now. Far out, we're on a heater. This is huge, guys. We're on a heater. Gonna rip it. That's a huge card for us. We're gonna check raise. Could check raise that turn, because then if he's got king queen, then we're worried. But apart from that, no. Really? He's got seven? That stinks. Back over the straddle. That was a shame. I don't know, I think ripping it there was fine. I think king queen gets stuck there, ace king calls. They're not going to have seven there that often. We did actually didn't four bet, which we probably should have. But it means a lot of his bad hands will actually still call that. So as much as it looks bad, there's a lot of hands that are calling. Jack's getting there, I don't know. They say it's no good anymore. That was not a good river card, it means he's probably got a straight. Got a call there, I've got flush draw, straight draw, every kind of draw you can think of. Get there on the river, I've got to bet it. Okay, flush draw with a 9-7. Yeah, I'm gonna call it. We've got a showdown hand, that's about it though. Unfortunately, we missed. But we didn't call. So, I mean, we didn't raise it at all and make it crazy. Pot queens are in trouble. King queen's gone. 10-4 suited. Let's get a bet there. We can hit our dream queen. Get there on the river. I hope he could have a weak king there. Look, because he did throw a bet in just to see where it is at. Sometimes that's someone with a weak king. Could have the second best, like a second pair hand there. Do we thin value? I think we're just valuing ourselves in, so it doesn't make sense. Going for the steal with king seven offsuit. No, I'm going to call in position. We could have the best hand with 10-7 suited. We hit the 10 on the flop. In position, two pair, beautiful. Let's get a raise in and see if we can bully him. Hopefully he's trying to trap us with aces and we just give him the tip. Just get a call behind, just in case there's a flush out there. Alright, let's get a call. That two is really bad for us, actually. Hopefully he's just whiffed it with ace king though, because if he's got an overpair now, he does beat us. And that's the only problem when you have low two cards like that. So hopefully we held up. Don't like our chances though, but he did slow up and he was playing like he had ace king. But a lot of good players will still play like that, even with, you know, pocket jacks, pocket tens. They just don't know what they're doing. Not pocket tens because we had tens, but all right, I'm gonna call one more with eights. I don't think eight's good there. Get to the river showdown bay, which is nice. Maybe we lost the hand because we don't have that $7 table anymore. Maybe we ran into a better hand with those queens. Although now we do have a green table that's got $5. It's just moving around a little bit. That's fine. As long as we're winning hands, who cares? It's hopefully winning more than losing. Which I think we are. I think majority of the hands, majority of the tables we've got a bit on now. King Jack with a bet. Hit the six and that's about it. That's not exciting. Eight six off suit's gone. So I think we've had a few bad beats. We'll just call as, you know. Mate, you know that king flush, maybe we got stuck with that one. Part of the fun. Let's just say it's character building. I'm gonna bet it. Hopefully he folds. Ace high beats us, so hopefully he folds with that. I got a flush draw. He didn't fold. He's got better than us. He probably got a pocket pair. He doesn't want to let go. All right, missed the flush. We got a better. So I think we're no good there. 8-7's gone. The two pairing up, you know, we've shown that we've had twos in our range from any position. Queen 8's gone. Not gonna call a 3-bet that wide. Pocket 3's is gone. Probably could have called one more just to see if we get that river miracle card. There's a king on the board and he's betting. Tells me that he's not scared of the king. If not, he could just have an ace king and that really helps him. Queen 9 missed, but we're just betting it like we've got something. So I mean, it's straddling again. Hit the ace. Good news, bad news. Bad kicker, but we hit the ace though. Good news is they checked twice now, which means we're getting to showdown, hopefully. We could probably just check call. Need a jack big time for hit the river, but there's a diamond out there. Can't believe they actually called the flop. Calling, but we need something. We got to the river with an ace, with a weak ace. Definitely happy with that. Ace queen got nothing. Probably looking at folding now. People three betting us. Open ender. Probably could have called the 10-9 actually. Such a bad river card, the ace. This fills in a lot of their draws. Tangis is betting into the wind. Top pair, top kicker with a flush draw. We're getting things in there, all in. Tens are no good. Probably shouldn't have bet there, actually. But you never know, they could have folded. This went an easy flop, but I'm gonna kill that guy. Not really. Okay, hit a 7. Hit a 7, but yeah. Just going value turn with sevens. If he's got ace king, good. Yeah, he's getting the news. We should be able to beat him quite easy there. Yeah, ace three actually. Whew, nice hand. Oh, he hits the three on the river, so it would have been a bad beat. So that's why you get the cash out. Yeah, what a hand. That's, you know, it's, that's actually nice because it means both people win. More people playing poker. Ace queen. Oh, king queen's gone. Alright, I wasn't gonna call ace four, but we decided to. Alright, top pair, top kicker. I don't know, he could have the best hand, but I'm gonna call. A low bet. It's a low bet. And flush is out there now. I'm gonna know if he's really got a good hand. Has he got me on the river, really? Ace 8 didn't get any love. I'm gonna bet there because I got the straight. Ace king we flat because he could actually be. I'm gonna let go. I've got top pair there, but and he can think that we've got the worst hand there. I'm gonna bet ace four suited. We got gut shot. We got top pair. Oh shit, kicker though, but. You got so many outs. You got straight draws, flush draws, whatever you like. We've got it. It's one of those hands where you just look to the future. Everything looks promising. And all it takes is one bad card, and then your world comes crashing down around you. Aces, there we go. I didn't call A6 offsuit. Am I sick or what? Alright, so gotta think this is actually a really good session so far. Been a few big hands, I reckon we've lost though. Which means it eats up a bit of the winnings. That's the worst board for kings I could think of. Give me a jack. Give me a jack and I don't have to stress. Check behind. He doesn't know what we got. We're not calling pocket queens there. We're calling king 10 there because all rivers seem to be pretty good. Could I have folding? I don't want to fold there. Alright, king 10 we're letting go. But we had a lot of rivers there that were looking really good for us. That's not our fault we didn't get there. We didn't overcommit. Well, I don't think we overcommitted. We just gave ourselves a chance. Just need a king for that hand. Got a 10, that's about it. Yeah, ace 2 is no good there. So we're 68th ranking with $3 points there. Actually, we should be getting pretty close, I think, to the end of the day. I think It's Pacific time, so Pacific time at the moment, it's 4 p.m. EST. But Pacific time is just a little bit, a couple hours behind, I think. But it's midday, I think. Or maybe ahead, maybe they're ahead a little. They're like almost a day behind. We'll just say that. We're betting trips there, and we're going to love it with a smile on our face. Got nines, pop twos. Ace nine. Any excuse? So it's just... No, I mean, I've got a bet there. Pocket nines is going to bet there. Hopefully, let's go. We've got a bad... We've got a good kicker, but we're going to let go there. It's too expensive for a shit hand. And there's... And if we're wrong, we don't really have a get-out-of-jail Capri card. Yeah, $15.60 on the other one, which is nice. $3 on the cash and run. So if we can play as long as we can, they're going bankrupt. Although I think we're actually up this session. I'm being a bit rough on myself. That's going to call Jack 9. Sometimes the big blind will squeeze in, you know. Yeah, it's actually a good spot for Ace Jack suited to actually squeeze. Alright, got a 9. We'll call. We'll bet the king because a lot of people fault the king. Which means we don't have to make our draw. That's always a nice thing, because you're never gonna make your draw all the time. Gonna let go Jack 9 there. I'm gonna realize sometimes when it starts to get a little bit too out of hand. Don't like our pocket twos back there. Ooh, we've got a pair of twos. Not pocket twos. Pocket fours is gone. Probably could have, with Jack suited hand, we probably could have stolen. Going for some light steals. Not stealing with Jack 5, no. Said that before, we could control ourselves. All open still pretty wide. Seven, six suited, not a bad hand. You know exactly where you are. That's way too expensive. Okay, it could be in front here though. Could be a good river. I reckon he hit the river. I reckon we're in front there for that one little turn card. Pocket Kings again. I don't think Pocket Kings have been great to us lately. Got a bet like there's no tomorrow. All right, got a straight flush draw. We're just totally bluffed at the other table. Hopefully it folds, but. Not what we wanted to see. We wanted to see anything else but that one. Get a jack. Oh, queen's getting that love. Look at tens, no love as well. Looks like Pocket Jacks might be getting a savior. Almost. But no cigar. Not king six, no. King queen just danced around that one. We're gonna fold that one. He just looks like he's quite a tight player. Okay, hit the seven on the river means we could still win that hand. 9-8's not gonna win. All right, we'll call that seven. We've got a bluff catcher there, that's about it though. 10-9, no good. Yeah, still no good. I could have probably opened with king, queen jack suited. Some aces and kings just to keep us entertained for a little bit during this quiet period. I got a 4-bet because last time we were 4-bet, we got caught in someone with an ace-7, which was a bit dirty. All right, top pair, good top kicker. Alright, we're not calling that. We only invested like 6 cents or something in that pot. Ace Queen should have bet there if that was a misclick. We were out of position, so. Okay, heads up there, 10-9. If he gets impatient, that guy, he's gonna raise me with pretty widely. And then sometimes you can think that he's doing that pretty widely, but he's not. He's just trying to play his cards. And you just overthink the situation. Queen pairing is a good board for us. Just no love. We'll get half a chance with the king because he got the showdown and he's playing it slow. Same as that king as well, they're playing quite low. I'm gonna fold just the fact that there's too many people in the hand. Not everyone's wrong. Very expensive at the end there. Big bet on the river. You better be right when you call that one. All the diamonds come out on the turn would be nice for that hand. No, didn't get there. They're nice on the river. And even that could be not good. They got hearts. Hopefully Ace Pearl gets there. Hopefully they all get there. Hopefully we just can't lose a hand in poker and we just win every single time. Wouldn't complain. Seven three, really. Too expensive. Just had a gut shot. Terrible river. When I hit the straight, we're gonna bet it. Looks like a bluff with Jack 10. Love if he's trying to trap us with aces and then just goes over the top and bets us. And it's a nice card. Now I've got a book. Keep betting it. Ace 7 off suit. Nah, I'm just gonna shovel in. Fuck him. We lost the hand. Oh no, we won the hand. Nice. Nice. Sometimes I think as soon as you see the GG care and all that, you get bad beated, but no. Call it. Alright, that's a good call actually. Alright, booked it. Spilling the heater. Apart from that one hand we've lost somehow. Oh, pff, we're calling. We're never folding that one. It's one thing to get good hands, but it's one thing to have your opponents on good hands as well. All better. We got no chance winning. Ace King valuing there, because if he's missed, he's, you know, he could be calling along trying to get with a king high board or a weaker king. Obviously, there's a chance that he folds as well, which is nice. Also, he can have lower pocket pairs, but we have a chance to draw out on him. So I think so far it's been a good session. We've got that table that's worth, you know, over $8, which is always a nice sign. And then we've got a couple of tables that are worth a little bit more, like $5. Obviously, we're still down on a couple of tables though. Oh, Queen's trying to hold on. But yeah, I'm definitely enjoying the more aggressive side. Shouldn't really play passive, that people walk over you. Don't be afraid to lose hands. Just get in the middle of it and, you know, as long as you're winning more hands than you're losing, enjoy the variance. And just think, if they bad beat you, it means bad players stay in the game longer. I like the 3-bet poker pairs, just the fact that we can definitely get stacks in a lot easier with deeper stack when the pot's bigger. Hopefully. Yeah, then we've got a heart, now we need a jack. Two pair, but we could be in trouble. We're calling one, I guess. We're not happy with the call, but we're gonna do it. Hopefully he doesn't have an ace and we get him on the river. That'd be just nice. Yeah, I'm not happy with that. Plus draw with the 8-7. Didn't get any help though. Probably could have bet it. Currently 14th in points. On one section, 64th on the other. But the cash and run table is always worth more point, more C dollars. It's King's beautiful. I will bet the 4. Sometimes they get strung along with a 10. Yeah, control ourselves. Not going to call 3-bet with such a white for the bad 2-suited hand. Five's gonna say hello, just see if he can bluff it. Check 10's just no love. We had a gut shot, but couldn't really be excited about it. Alright, we're gonna fold there. Could easily have a queen, we just don't have a great. Probably could have check raised with the open straight draw. Still got the open ender. He made it cheap enough to call on the turn, so he wants to lose the hand, which is nice. It's up to the poker gods now. Poker gods say no. Could be trying to bait us into doing something stupid on the river, like raising. Ace 8 with calling. Well, calling, but we weren't getting crazy about it. All right, 10-9 suited. It's got two pair. We actually folded there with the check raise. Quite deep stacked, so. Ten nine suited. Ace two suited. Let's go. We'll bet there. We got the ace. Another spade comes out, we're in trouble. Do get some value from spade calls, I guess. I don't know. Yeah, going out of that hand. Yeah, so I've got two tables of about $5, one table at about $9. And then 487 one. We'll call 10-9 suited. It's pretty wide, but... Alright, we have a... gut shot and diamond draw. Queen 10 offsuit's just no great hand. No, I'm gonna call one just to see if we can spike a four. Oh, we spiked the two though. Horse could be good against everything else. If he's got an. If he's got his queen, we beat him. So we'll call. Alright, he's gonna get the tip. Another hand that we should win there. Queen jack suited. Did we actually lose the hand? Sometimes it takes a while to get back there. No, I think we did all right actually. Surely we won that hand. Alright, hit a straight, but we have a flush draw, so if he's got a king, he's going to be happy to call it. Oh, I got a call. Could have the worst hand there, but... can't always fold. Yeah, calling with a two, I don't think so. Goes all in. Yeah, the people are restless. All right, I'm gonna call it. I've been going a while with this session. Finish off. First hand for ace king. Needed the jack, but not the jack of diamonds, so I was glad to fold that one. I can we can call the river. Because you checked the ace. Check behind. Probably could have bet there on the river, just a min bet. Alright, let's close the table, see what the damage is. Could be up, could be down. Pretty positive, but I know we lost a few tables. Up $2, wow. So yeah, we definitely lost a few games there, but we went up. Definitely a bit of a roller coaster. Probably be a bit more aggressive. What's the promo look like with the leaderboard? Sitting 14th, but we're going to lose those rankings soon. It might stick around a little bit longer. Daily freebie, will we get one? An hour and 22. What's the rewards program look like? I don't know. It shouldn't be just at 1900 now. It hasn't moved up since. But we started since the 5th. What's the date today? The 8th. So it'll accumulate once the... So maybe it hasn't counted the two sessions that we played yet today. So we played two sessions so far today. And hopefully it goes up. Anyway, and then hopefully get some C$ there. So definitely getting some good experience. Not falling down by any means. We did have a few hands there. We must have had a lot of second best hands. A few callers as well. There was ones where we had that jack three hand and we booked it. Possibly had something there, like, you know, maybe had quads, just something weird. Maybe had just a caller. You know, maybe had a set and then he booked it as well. Something like that. It just happens. I think there was about two hands like that. And then there was... that king high flush draw I was talking about ages ago. So I think there's about two or three hands we really just got unlucky with where we just get it in. One or two of them probably just bad beats. And then we actually done a lot of good hands as well in the middle there as well. So overall, that's the figures at the moment. So let's go from there. And hopefully you guys enjoy it. Just let me know, hey, do you rather just watch it? Do you like me talking through the hands? No face. Just let me know. Anyway, guys, this is it. So we're going to try and get to the shrimp, obviously. Try to get the 6,000. Like I said previously, once we work out we can't get to the next... We'll be able to get the bronze shrimp pretty easy, I believe. But once we can't get to the next section, that's when we'll go to platinum. So we'll have to just... It's just a matter of we'll just have to make the call when the time's right. I think we're well off getting there at the, you know, we're not at the tipping point yet. Why don't we just go back to work? We'll have to reassess as well. So how many points we can get in the week. I think it's 6,000 points you need in two weeks to actually get, 15 days there, to get bronze shrimp anyway. So at worst, I think we could still get 6,000 anyway, because in 2 weeks, I mean, surely we can get 6,000 points in 2 weeks. So we could average 300. Actually, probably averaging more than 300 a session, because I'm not sure, but we'll see how much it jumps up today. So it's 1933 today. we'll see you next time on the next video what we're at. We'll go from there. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching. Surprised it's like 47. I thought we're going to be in the 50s easy that time, or not 60s. I thought we hit a heater. Maybe I did get carried away at the heat of the moment. There was a few hands there where we got really excited, and then maybe I was just trying to run it where it wasn't there. But you know what? That's half the challenge. But yeah, thanks, guys. See ya.